We are going to discuss a selection of number of poles problems. We discussed four eligible criteria while solving your selection of not 4, 3. So first one is frequency of flux reversal we have to check. So this is the first guidelines. The relation is F equal to NP by 2. So the frequency should be in the range of 25 to 50. So lower frequency is preferred for large machine. In case of small machines, we have to use high frequency. So remember, the frequency should be NP by 2. N is speed in RPS, P is number of poles divided by 2. So the frequency should be 25 to 50 hertz. So based on this guidelines, we are going to solve one problem. So that problem is problem number 7. Find the main dimensions and the number of poles of a 37 kilowatt, 230 volt, 1400 RPM DC shunt motor. Just a minute. DC shunt motor, so that a square pole phase is obtained. The average gap density BG is 0.6 Weber per meter square and ampere conductors per meters are 24,000. The ratio of pole arc to pole pitch is 0.67 and the full load efficiency is 90%. So this is the problem. So in the previous class problems, we are determined only the main dimensions. So kona class la namba the main dimensions are DL. Number PA equal to C naught BAV AC N 10 power minus 3 port. We determined the value for D and L alone in the previous problems. But in this session, we are going to determine the number of poles. So in this problem, the number of poles is not given. So based on the relation F is equal to NP by 2, we have to find out the number of poles also, in addition to that main dimensions. So the ratio of pole arc to pole pitch is 0.67 and full load efficiency is 90%. So these are all the given. PA is 37 kilowatts, poles is 230, N is 1400. So in this problem, they clearly mentioned it is square pole phase. So square pole phase means L by B equal to 1 or L equal to B, both are same. And then average flux density is 0.6 Weber per meter square. And ampere conductors is 24,000, B by tau, tau or B, AV by BG, psi, everything is 0.67. Eta is 90%, that is 0.9. We have to find out main dimensions D and L and number of poles P. So as usual, the power developed by armature PA equal to C naught D square L N in kilowatts. For motor, in case of your high rating motors, your PA equal to P. This is the general equation we have. In case of generator, it is P by eta. So large machines means we have losses. So this is in the case of motor, your armature, developed armature power equal to your actual power. So PA should be 37 kilowatts. And then the output coefficient C naught is pi square BAV AC into 10 power minus 3. So pi square value we know, BAV is 0.6, AC is 24,000 into 10 power minus 3. Determine the answer for C naught. So once you determine the value for C naught, find out your N, small N, that is speed in RPS, your capital N by 60. So once you find out the value for small N, you just substitute all the values in the PA expression in order to get a D square L. Okay, தூரம். So what is C naught? So determine the value for C naught first. So pi square into 0.6 into 24,000 into 10 power minus 3. I am getting 142.12. What is the answer for C naught?
Yes, sir. Good, sir.
Is 142.12. So your RPS should be n by 60. That is 1400 by 60. You may get 23.33. So once C naught and n is determined, substitute in PA equation. So we know that PA equal to 37 kilowatts. C naught is 142.12, D square L is unknown, and N should be 23.33. So 37 divided by the entire thing, 142.12 into 23.33. You may get a D square L. So name the expression as 1. So what do you get for D square L?
0.01115.
11 continuous ஆ போயிட்டே இருக்கா?
Yes sir.
Okay, 0.0111 னு வெச்சுக்கலாம். So naming the expression as. So next we know that square pole phase L equal to B. So L equal to B 1 means L equal to B. So B by tau is nothing but psi, it is 0.67. So in order to equating this equation, that is L equal to B is nothing but 0.67 times of tau, where tau is nothing but pole pitch equation is pi d by p. Okay, well, now substituted here in L value, so you may get L as 0.67 into pi. D value is unknown and then P value is also unknown, correct? Nammalku number of poles vandu pona case la kuduttaanga, namba L D kandupidichitom, but here we doesn't know the value for P. So adukku vandu namba first criterion porom. So I have to check what is my number of poles. Indha P theriyad illaya, adukaga vendi I am going for first guidelines. What is the first guideline? That is F equal to NP. So இதில் வந்து நம்ம substitute பண்ணி பார்க்க போகிறோம். நம்ம எப்பவுமே வந்து number of poles it should be in the even manner. Pole pair தான் நம்மளுக்கு ஆட்ல வராது இல்லையா போல்ஸ். அதனால வந்து P equal to 2, P equal to 4, P equal to 6, P equal to 8, like that we have to substitute arbitrarily. நான் சப்ஸ்டியூட் பண்ணியிருக்கேன் பாருங்க. பாருங்க, ஐ எம் யூசிங் த கைட்லைன்ஸ் ஃபார் செலெக்ஷன் ஆஃப் நம்பர் ஆஃப் போல்ஸ். ஸோ வாட் இஸ் த எலிஜிபிள் கிரைட்டீரியா? இட் ஷுட் பி த ஃப்ரீக்வன்சி ஷுட் பி லைஸ் வித் இன் த ரேஞ்ச் ஆஃப் 25 to 50. ஸோ இதுக்குள்ளே இருந்தால் தட் போல் இஸ் சாட்டிஸ்ஃபை, அதர்வைஸ் இட் இஸ் நாட். ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கேஸ் ஐ எம் சப்ஸ்டியூட்டிங் பி ஈக்குவல் டு 2. ஸோ எஃப் ஈக்குவல் டு 23.33, தட் இஸ் ஸ்மால் என். பி இஸ் 2 divided by 2, 2 to get cancelled. So 2 to get cancelled means the value should be, hertz, correct? அடுத்தாப்புல வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, when P equal to 4, F is equal to, N is 23.33 and pole is 4. So இங்கே வந்து 2க்கு 2 cancel ஆயிடுமா, 23.33 into 2. What do you get? 46.66. So in the frequency paranga, idu vandu pathina, it is within the 50 hertz. So appa in the frequency is satisfied. So this frequency should be satisfied. So, if we add to them, path it long. So, P equal to 6, 23.33 into 6 divided by 3. Sorry, 2. So, if 23.33 into 3 port path, you may get 69.99. So, it is more than 50 hertz. So, this frequency is not satisfied. So, in the F1 on the not eligible, அதே போல இந்த எஃப் வந்து நாட் எலிஜிபிள். ஆனால் எஃப் ஈக்குவல் பி ஈக்குவல் டு ஃபோரில் கிடைக்கிற எஃப் வந்து இட் ஷுட் பி இந்த ரேஞ்ச் ஆஃப் 25 to 50 ஹெர்ட்ஸ். ஸோ த நம்பர் ஆஃப் போல் ஷுட் பி 4. ஸோ ஒன்லி வி ஆர் செலக்டிங் பி ஈக்குவல் டு 4. நவ் யூ சப்ஸ்டிடியூட் எல் ஈக்குவல் டு 0.67 பை டி பை பி. இன் பி யூ சப்ஸ்டியூட் 4. ஸோ 0.67 இன்டு பை divided by 4, you may get 0.5262. Correct?
Yes, sir. 0.5262,
naming the equation as 2. Now substitute 2 in 1. So 2 in L equal to 0.526D. In D square L, we know that 0.0111. So 0 D square 0.5262, 2 use panniko. D equal to 0.0111. You may get a D cube as 0.0211. Once you are taking cube root, you may get a D value. So what is the D value? That is 0.0111 divided by 0.5262.
0.276.
0.276. So once D வந்து நம்மளுக்கு தெரிஞ்சிச்சுன்னா நீங்கள் எல்ல சப்ஸ்டியூட் பண்ணுறங்க. நவ் சப்ஸ்டியூட் D ஈக்குவல் டு 0.276 இன் எல் ஈக்குவேஷன், தட் இஸ் இன் டூ. ஸோ இஃப் யூ ஆர் சப்ஸ்டியூட்டிங் யூ மே கெட் எல். வாட் இஸ் யுவர் எல் வேல்யூ?
0.145.
0.145 meters. So in this manner we have to select the number of poles. I'll say once again for selecting number of poles. So first selection of number of poles is your frequency should be in the range of 25 to 50 hertz. So we know that F is equal to NB by 2. So we have pole pairs. So we have to check 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 in the even manner. So first condition I am substituting when P equal to 2 in F equation, I may get 23.33. So 23.33 obviously less than your 25. So it is not satisfied. Again, I have the criteria when P equal to 4, my F should be 23.33 into 4 divided by 2. So this equation should be modified as 46.66. So this value of the frequency within the range of 25 to 50 hertz. So this is clearly possible. The P equal to 4, F is equal to 46.66 is eligible criterion to solve our problem because it is within the range. So next point also we have to check, because in the forthcoming problem, we have two number of poles. We have 4 is also satisfied. We have 6 is also satisfied. So in that case, we have another eligible criteria. ஸோ அதை நம்ம அடுத்தது பார்க்க போகிறோம். ஸோ இங்கே வந்து எஃப் வந்து 69.99, இது வந்து மோர் தென் 50 போகிறதுனால இது நாட் எலிஜிபிள். இப்போ பி வந்து 4 சொல்லிட்டு எல்லில் சப்ஸ்டியூட் பண்ணிட்டீங்க அப்படின்னா செகண்ட் ஈக்குவேஷன் கிடைச்சிடும். நவ் யூ பிளே வித் யுவர் ஈக்குவேஷன் 2 and 1. ஐதர் யூ கேன் சால்வ் யுவர் எல் எக்ஸ்பிரஷன் ஆர் டி எக்ஸ்பிரஷன். நீங்கள் ரெண்டு ஈக்குவேஷனையும் சால்வ் பண்ணிங்கன்னா யூ மே கெட் யுவர் டி அண்ட் எல். ஸோ அதை தான் நம்ம இங்கே செஞ்சுருக்கோம். ஸோ வி ஆர் அப்டைனிங் த வேல்யூ ஃபார் டி அண்ட் எல். Finally, you have a result. So armature diameter, I am getting 0.276 meter. Armature core length, L is equal to 0.145. And number of poles, P equal to 4. So this is my result. So is it clear to everyone? If you have any queries or doubt means, you may ask now. Regarding this problem, problem number 7. While selecting number of poles, you may have any issues. ஏன் 44 பேர் தான் இருக்கா மொத்தம் எல்லாம் எங்க போயிட்டான் இன்னைக்கு இவ்வளோ ஆப்சன்டீஸ் நேற்று 60 பேர் இருந்தீங்களே ஓகே ஓகே ஐ வில் மூவ் ஆன் டு தி நெக்ஸ்ட் ப்ராப்ளம் ask your friends to join ma again I have two problems is most important en kaalanga thala somberi mari thoongin irukananga unga group la dhaan message thatti viduma find the suitable diameter core length and the number of poles of a 400 kilowatt 550 volt 900 rpm dc generator having 92% efficiency assume an average flux density in the gap is 0.6 weber per meter square ampere conductors per meter to be 35000 and pole arc to pole pitch ratio is 0.7 so these are all the details which is given in the problem we need to calculate yes we need to find out your number of poles armature diameter core length these are all the given details So it is a DC generator, not motor. In previous case, we have discussed our DC motor. This is your DC generator. Remember. So we know that PA equal to C naught D square L N in kilowatts, as usual. In case of generator, my PA equal to P by eta. In case of motor, PA equal to P. Remember, ka. So in case of motor, we are taking PA equal to P. In case of generator, PA equal to P by eta. So 400 is given divided by 92%, that is from 0.92. So your PA should be 434.78. Are you getting the same answer? So I am getting the same answer. 434.78 kilowatts. So next one is my C square. Pi square BAV AC into 10 power 3. Pi square we know 0.6 35,000 into 10 power minus 3. I am getting my C naught value. So substitute manne pi square into 0.6 into 35,000 into 10 power minus 3. So I am getting 207.26. I am approximating to 207 alone. So now 207 is achieved. My C naught should be 207, and the N should be 900 rpm divided by 60. You may get speed in rps, 15 rps. So we know the expression PA equal to C naught D square L N. So PA is 434.78, and C naught is 207. D square L is unknown into 15. So what you get 434.78 divided by 207 into 15 I am getting 0.14 have you got the same answer or different so if I am calculated in my values I may get the same answer so 0.14005 So 14 at the top hole. So name the expression as 1. Just name the expression as 1. So next one is we are choosing square pole face L equal to L by B equal to 1 or L equal to B. As usual, pole arc by pole pitch value is given as 0.7. So L equal to B equal to 0.7 times of tau. So tau is pole pitch pi d by p. I am substituting here. So L equal to 0.7 pi d by p. So the p is unknown to us. It doesn't know the poles. We have to select the number of poles. So first case, we have to check the frequency of flux reversal lies between 25 to 50 hertz or not. So when I am substituting P equal to 2, 15 into 2 divided by 2. So 2 get cancelled, only you have 15 hertz. So it is not satisfied. Next one is P equal to 4, 15 into 4 divided by 2. So 15 into 2, 30 hertz. So it is satisfied because within 25 to 30. Next one, when P equal to 6, F is equal to 15 into 6 by 2. So 2, 3. 15 threes are 45. So here two poles are satisfied. P equal to 4 is also satisfied. And P equal to 6 is also satisfied. In this case, what we are trying to do? So we have to check the second eligible criterion. So what is your second case? Second guideline should be, yes, this is the second guidelines. The value of current per parallel path should be limited to 200 amps, 200 cooler. And then current per brush arm should be 400 amps. And then the nature of winding also we have to check. In case of wave winding means your current per parallel path is IA by 2. And current per brush arm is IA. Whatever you are getting the armature current, the same value. In case of lap winding means IA by P. And then your current per brush arms in case of lap winding is 2 IA by P. We have to remember the four relations. So if these values satisfied, 200 and 400 means it is satisfied. So the following pole is satisfied. Otherwise it is not satisfied. I'll check. So we have to check the frequency of flux reversal, two poles satisfied. Either my pole should be 4 or 6. So edu ipo rendathula edu venum nammalku abindrada check panna porom. 4 venuma illa 6 venuma nu solittu. So modalla vandu pathina enakku enna theriyum, power equal to V into IL theriyum. Seriyama? So my P should be 400 kilowatts which is given and my voltage is 550 given, IL doesn't know. Correct. So pathina ungalku 400 into 10 cube divided by 550. So 727.27 varum. So your IL. So you may get 727.27 amps varum. So in this problem, the specification of generator is not mentioned. So the nature of the generator is not specified. So I am assuming IL equal to IA. So for wave winding, current per parallel path. So current per parallel path should be 200. And the current per brush arm should be 400. So in the limit of the limit, irka illiya endradha nama paakapom. So current per parallel path IA by 2, 727 divided by 2, it is 363.5. So not satisfied because it is less than 200. And current per brush arm is IA 727. Idhum vandhu 400 kulla irukum, not satisfied. Rendume vandhu wave winding vandhu satisfy agadhu. அடுத்து வந்து லேப் வைண்டிங் பார்க்கலாம். ஸோ லேப் வைண்டிங்கில் வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா நம்மளுக்கு ரெண்டு போல்ஸ் கிடைச்சிது, ஒன்று பி ஈக்குவல் டு 4, ஒன்று பி ஈக்குவல் டு 6. ஸோ முதல்ல வந்து நம்ம பி ஈக்குவல் டு 4 பார்த்துடலாம். ஸோ வென் பி ஈக்குவல் டு 4 மீன்ஸ் கரண்ட் பர் பேரல் பார்த்தா ஐஏ பை பி, தட் இஸ் 727/4. யூ மே கெட் 181.75. ஸோ இட் இஸ் சாட்டிஸ்ஃபைட், இட் இஸ் லெஸ் தென் 200. கரெக்டாக 200க்கு கம்மியாக இருக்குது, அதனால் இது சாட்டிஸ்ஃபைட். அடுத்தாப்பில் கரண்ட் பர் ப்ரஷ் ஆம் 2IA பை பி, 2 × 727 டிவைடட் பை 4. ஸோ 363.5. So 363.5, so it is satisfied less than 400. So P equal to 400 on the number, sorry, P equal to 4 la current per parallel path satisfy agadhu and current per brush arm rendu me satisfy agadhu. So we may check your P equal to 6 also. So when P equal to 6 vandu paathina 727 by 6 IA by P. So you may get 121.16. So idhu was satisfied. 121.16. Next vandu paathina 2 into 727 divided by 6. So 242.33. So idhum vandu satisfy agudhu. So ipo nammalku confusion rendathula what p equal to 4 or choice p equal to 6 per choice rendume vandu nammalku satisfy da agudhu. Ipo namba idha assumption vechittu enna poles choose pannalam. So by using the second guideline it can be satisfied by both poles rendume satisfy agudhu. P equal to 4 is also satisfied, P equal to 6 is also satisfied. Therefore, chose a number of poles as large value. So, epume vandu number of poles vandu large a edukkuradhu nalladhu. So, naan neethu class nadathum bodhu sonna naan. So, if more than one choice of pole satisfies the above mentioned three conditions, then select a large number of poles. Ellame satisfy aayiduchu appadina neenga edhu largest la satisfy a irukko andha poles vandu eduthukalam. Why not? This results in reduction in iron and copper. So iron loss um copper loss um vandu koraikkaradhukaga we are using that large number of poles. Yen sir 4 a poirukalam appadina 4 pola losses rendathilum irukum iron loss copper loss ad avoid pandrathukaga large poles porom. So I am choosing P equal to 6. Now substitute L equal to 0.7 pi d divided by 6. So 0.7 into pi a divided by 6. You may get 0.3665. Correct? L equal to 3665. This is the equation number 1 in which conga. D square L already, sorry, 2 is. But d square l on the already 1 and vechirukom. So this is your 2, substitute 2 in 1. That is l equal to 0.3665 in d square l. D square l is 0.14. So 0.3665 d. So, if on the d cube, we will answer 0.14 divided by 0.3665. So, while taking cube root of this value, I am getting 0.3819 is my d cube, and 0.725 is my d. Is it correct or not? My value should be correct or not? D cube thappa varudho 0.04 potta 0.14 by 0.3665 varudhu nammalku correct dhaan correct 3665 potta. Okay, no issues. 0.725 meter vandirukku. So now substitute 0.725 in your L equation. So inga thappa vandirukku nammalku idu illa 0.725 illaya. So 0.725. So 0.3665 into 0.725. I am getting 265. L value should be 0.265 meter. now modify your result also. So D equal to 725 and L equal to 0.265 meter and number of poles equal to 6. So in this manner we have to select our number of poles. So first selection of poles is also satisfied. Second eligible guidelines is also satisfied. Sariya, idu vandu rendu problem vandu nammalku based on your number of poles. So this is the problem based on number of poles. இன்னொரு ப்ராப்ளம் லென்த்தியான ப்ராப்ளம் அதை நம்ம போட்டோம்னா நம்மளுக்கு டைம் ஆகிடும். ஸோ ஐ ஷோ த பிடிஎஃப் மோதர் ஆப்ஷன் இன் இட். ஆன்சர்ஸ் மட்டும் நம்ம கரெக்டாக வருதா இல்லையான்னு செக் பண்ணிகிட்டே வரலாம்.